Just in me, oh Let's all sing now and welcome everybody. It's good to see you here. Well, good morning, everybody, and it's good to be with you this morning. And can I give a special welcome to those who are visitors with us, and an extra special welcome to the Rainbows and to the Brownies and the guides who are standing outside, who will be coming in shortly, and that, because you're here for... We're very different from everybody else in Castle Hill. I know most other churches are celebrating World Thinking Day next week, but we're celebrating it this week. hopefully it'll just be every bit as good. We pause this day and look around into the world that needs this time, this season, this moment to reflect, to confess, to repent. May we gather and travel the world through this time of cleansing and renewal. Let us worship in the Spirit lives to set us free. I wonder if any of you can tell me what last Wednesday was. Yes, Poppy. It was Valentine's Day. And here's an even harder question. What date was that? Yes? The 14th of February. And this is the hardest question of all. And we'll maybe look for the adults to answer this one. Because this year, Valentine's Day, the 14th of February, wasn't just Valentine's Day. It was the start of a very special time in the church that takes us, we're starting from Wednesday and we're carrying right on till Easter. And it begins with L. Lent, yes, yeah. Very good about that. It's a series of, if we can have so whether you got a Valentine or not, it doesn't really matter, because I'll give you the solution to it later on in a minute. But this year is, in fact, this week is a whole lot of anniversaries. It wasn't just Valentine's Day, it wasn't just the start of Lent, but it's 100 years since a very special type of sweets started being made that were given out by people who wanted to say that they loved somebody. Love hearts, yes, you watch the news too. Yeah. The love hearts there, and if you see the next slide there, you've got lots of different names on them, and if you look onto the next, love hearts have come up to date since I gave out love hearts, because nowadays you can have Skype me, tweet me, swipe right, take a selfie. So it's obviously that love hearts are going to be with us for a wee while yet. And that's but something else that's been spoken about quite a bit just now, and this is really quite a hard question. This is, what is AI? Does anybody know? Yeah. Very good, very good. Yes, artificial intelligence. And artificial intelligence, as we'll see in the next slide, it's different things in life. But I heard something last week which I thought was quite amusing, because have you ever had problems getting a boyfriend? Have you? Have you ever had bother getting a boyfriend? No, you've not had any bother. Well, if you do, the perfect boyfriend is apparently an AI boyfriend. Because it's not somebody you've to persuade to become your boyfriend. It's somebody that you actually make up, and you put in all the bits about the boy that you like and all the bits you want to have in a boyfriend, and he becomes an AI boyfriend. And he only says nice things to you, and he only tells you the things you want to hear. And he always thinks of you first. And it doesn't do anything nasty to you at all. It's really, they haven't heard whether they make AI girlfriends yet, but one of the things that in Lent, we it's not just a make-up type of love, whether it's Valentine's Day or it's an AI boyfriend. But we talk a bit about love, and that's we start today on Jesus' journey up to show us what love is all about. And the next slide it's showing us that love must be real. Love, if it's going to mean anything, has got to be real. AI is fine because apparently you can talk to your AI boyfriend 24 hours a day on your phone. Your mums might not like it too much, but it's not real. You wouldn't actually get to see him. And love has got to be real. And love means having hard times as well as good times. And Jesus said, listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who do you wrong. That's the type of hard love that we've got to show as well. Even the people we don't like sometimes, and people who don't like us, we've got to, if we're going to follow Jesus on the walk to Easter, then we've got to try and do that as well. Most of us try to do that some of the time, but since this week, who can tell me what date is World Thinking Day? Yeah? It's the 22nd, that's right. So it's in the middle of the week, so we opted to start early, to be out early for it. So on World Thinking Day, it's a good day to start thinking about the walk to Easter, which we do in Lent. But before that, I'm really going to get you to think, because I'm going to ask your leaders to come out just now, and we're going to hear your promises. And so, Ashley, would you like to come out my beliefs, kind and helpful. Oh, yeah, sorry, the next one. If you can have the next slide, Scott. Well, we can do it without a slide, can we? Yeah. That's good. Well done. That's you signed up for another year. You realise that? So we look forward to seeing you all through the year in all your activities. So let's sing now in the song, We Will Walk With God, My Brother, We Will Walk With God, My Sister. What do we call the time that we said before Easter was called again? Begins with an L. Lent, that's right, Lent. An even more difficult question, how many days are there in Lent? Forty, yeah. Well, what I've got is something for lots of people talk about Lent as being a time when you give up something. You know, it's a time when you stop doing something you like. So if you like eating chocolate, you stop eating chocolate. Do you like eating chocolate? I like eating chocolate too, and I don't think that's a very good idea that way. I think a better idea is the way that instead of giving something up, we should take something up and give it. So what I've got for each of you, for all of you today, is you can find out the first right up to the end. And that. And on the back, it's got different things you can do. One thing for each day, and it's tidy an untidy area, hold the door open for somebody, tidy up somebody else's lunch for them, hold the door open for a teacher or an adult. I think the schools I go into, they do that very well, don't you? Yeah, that's pick up your clothes and put them in the washing basket. No, we don't do that very well, do we? No. Let someone go in front of you in the queue. Maybe you could think about it. Say thank you to someone who helps you. Help a friend put on their coat, especially today because it's wet. Right? So lots of things you can do. Do one a day. Can you do that? You get them. Jeanette's got them, and she'll give them out to you before you go, and you're not exempt. If we go on to the next slide, it's about the walk of Lent, from Lent through to what we call Holy Week, and then Easter. And this year, the really good thing is that you'll be in. I think, when do you go on holiday from school? Do you know yet? 29th, yeah. So it's the 29th of March. You go on holiday, and that's just before Easter, because Easter this year is on the 31st of March. So 2 days before Easter is Good Friday, and that's when you go on holiday. But right at the start of Lent, the first story we tell about Jesus is, and this is where, you ever taken a selfie? Yes, yeah, you have, right. Well, there's now what's called a selfie Bible, and this is the story of Jesus when he spent 40 days out, and that's where we get the 40 days for Lent, out in the desert. Right out in the wilderness, and he was tempted then. And if we just go through them very quickly, you'll see the different pictures. It's from Matthew, and we'll tell the story later like that. It's and that's he's being tempted with that. That's meant to be I'm not quite sure they actually had mobiles and mobile phones in Jesus' day, but they've created all the different ones, the story of Jesus being out in the desert. But you've been quiet too long, and the adults have been quiet too long too, so will we have a quiz? Will we? Right? It's a quiz about patience. Now, you've been very patient up till now, so you should be able to answer these questions quite easily like that. What is the average amount of time a person in Britain spends waiting throughout their life? Is it 3 months, 18 months, or 5 years? Yeah, you've obviously all had to wait. Yeah, right, let's see if we're right. Yeah, 5 years it is, right. In the tale of the tortoise and the hare, who wins the race? Is it the tortoise, the hare, or the tie? Let's see if we're right. Let's see. Yeah, right, tortoise, that's right, that's good, right. In the flood, that's the story in the Bible, with Noah, how many days and nights did Noah have to wait before it stopped raining? 40 days. Let's see if we're right. 40 days it is, yeah. 40 keeps coming up, doesn't it? 40, 40 in Lent and 40 in that as well. Who sings the song Patience? Take that. Let's see if we're right. Take that it is, yeah, right. Take that it is. And in which book of the Bible, this is for the adults especially, which book of the Bible is there a chapter all about time? Ecclesiastes. Let's see if we're right. Yes, Ecclesiastes is right with that. Which scientist wrote A Brief History of Time? Stephen Hawking, let's see if we're right. Yeah, that's right, good. What's the name of the book by H.G. Wells in which a man travels in time? The Time Machine, yes. Are these too easy for you, are they? How many years did Joseph spend in prison before being released? And the answer isn't 40. years. Let's see, are we right, Scott? Well, I think that's moved a wee bit on the slide, so it should in fact be 13 years. 13 years is it. And all of us find it hard to wait, don't we? And we need to wait, it's good to ask God to help us to when we need patience, and he'll help us to find the patience to wait for whatever it is in life. Because the one thing I can guarantee you is we're all going to have to wait at some time, and that's something which will help. Let's sing again about walking. Walk with me, oh my God. Thank you. Let's pray. Loving God, may we feel your breath in the words we whisper in this place. About broken prayers and hesitant confession, long pauses where there are no words, times where we've had to wait. Lord Jesus, may we know your presence in all the stuff of life that we bring to this place especially, our laughter and our hurts, our anger and our fear, our whole being human that clashes too much with the inhumanity in the world outside. Holy Spirit of God, may we be aware here of something special in story and hope, in sanctuary and heaven, laid here for all, in word and friendship. And in this place, may we reshape our community and hold our world. May we speak words of love into the words of fear. May we live into the peace of God in the conflicts of this world especially, but in the little conflicts we all experience. May we make this place holy by the lives we lead and simply by being here, honestly, fully, just as we are. And may we meet you among us and between us, one of us. Hear our prayer now, as in one voice we share the worldwide prayer given by Jesus. And we say together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen. Listen now for a word from God, which is brought to us by Margaret. I think it's true to say you used to be a brownie guider, is that right? So,
our reading this morning is from Isaiah chapter 58, verses 6 to 12. The kind of fasting I want is this: remove the chains of oppression and the yoke of injustice, and let the oppressed go free. Share your food with the hungry, and open your homes to the homeless poor. Give clothes to those who have nothing to wear, and do not refuse to help your own relatives. Then my favor will shine on you like the morning sun, and your wounds will be quickly healed. I will always be with you to save you. My presence will protect you on every side. When you pray, I will answer you. When you call to me, I will respond. If you put an end to oppression, to every gesture of contempt, and to every evil word, if you give food to the hungry and satisfy those who are in need, then the darkness around you will turn to the brightness of noon, and I will always guide you and satisfy you with good things. I will keep you strong and well. You will be like a garden that has plenty of water, like a spring of water that never runs dry. Your people will rebuild what has long been in ruins, building again on the old foundations. You will be known as the people who rebuilt the walls, who restored the ruined houses. Amen.
Thank you very much. Let's sing again in Singing We Gladly Worship the Lord. Can I say that was really good, because I think a lot of you didn't know that at the start, but you were singing it at the end. And that was really good. So thanks. Thanks. Isaiah's words of challenge and promise, read often at the start of Lent, are addressed to people in a situation that's painfully easy for us to picture because, let's be honest, we see it every day on our news. And streets are in ruins, ancient monuments have been destroyed, people are hungry and homeless, there's injustice and oppression which are rife. Just now, the International Red Cross and the International Red Crescent are dealing with no fewer than 33 ongoing emergency situations. Famine, flood, earthquake, war, mass migration, and so many others. Suffering on this scale is hard for anyone to deal with. But it raises particular questions for those who believe, or who would like to believe, in God as many people present God. Why has God caused or allowed this tragedy to happen? Why do we have to win back God's favor so that peace and well-being may be restored? These questions are there in the Bible. These questions are asked every day in our world today. Our reading today addresses people in the Bible who have been away from their home for several generations, many of them born in exile. They've never seen the temple in Jerusalem or experienced worship there. And they need to be reminded what really matters, what's the core, and what's the really important part of their faith. The temptation when the world is just too hard is to withdraw from the world and just shut yourself away. Sometimes people do that just by coming and trying to shut themselves in a quiet place, or even by coming to church. The prophet Isaiah, though, like Amos before him and Jesus after him, made it clear that withdrawal from the world wasn't an option for those whose commitment was to God. The one who had always been on the side of the poor, who valued justice and mercy above any other kind of purity and observance. And in case there was any doubt about what that was meant to mean in practice, he spells out in no uncertain terms what God expects of people before they even think of offering prayers for themselves. If their own lives are to be rich and fulfilling, we need to stop thinking about ourselves and focus on the needs of others. Share our food with the hungry. Give decent clothing to those who are in rags. Welcome the homeless poor into their homes, instead of, as is currently being proposed, lock them up if they happen to be homeless. If they want to remain free from enemy oppression, then we have to be sure that we are not ourselves guilty of carrying out some abuse on others. What's needed is nothing less than a whole-scale revision of attitudes to other people, of the way that society is organized. Once all of that has been tackled, everything else can start to fall into place, including our relationships with God. As far as the Old Testament people were concerned, not only would their ruined city be rebuilt, the whole of creation will burst into life once more. The relevance of that to modern times doesn't really need to be spelt out, whether that's in terms of international politics, the ever-widening gap between rich and poor, or in the tremendous drop in all religions in the Western world. Perhaps the best response as we enter Lent may be to listen to the silence, to these ancient words of wisdom, and let them take root in us and change us. We are to share our bread with those who are hungry. We are to give shelter to those without a home. We are to provide clothing for those who need it. We are to make sure we do not neglect the needs of our own family. God chooses, we're told, to practice freedom and justice through the way you and I live our daily lives. God has told us clearly what is expected of us. If we live this way, God will be near us. If we call for help, God will say, "Here I am." If we live this way, God will be our light, our guide, and our healer. And God will help us to rebuild peace and justice to the streets of our broken world. Let's sing again a hymn of discipleship. Here I am, Lord. Don't know the verses, try the chorus. That's good. Well, I have to say, if we're going on enthusiasm, we could definitely have a brownie choir. if we can turn to the intimations, teas and coffees are available in the main hall afterwards, and everyone is invited to them. Monday, the bowling. Tuesday, the coffee morning. Thursday afternoon, the warm space, the details are there. Thank you to all those who have donated to the food bank again, and the updated list of what's needed is given there. And the food bank, that's the South Ayrshire Food Bank, which is takes place in Prestwick, is looking for able-bodied people to help with the warehouse at Prestwick. on a Thursday between 10 and 12 or 12 to 2. And apparently, we've been told to forewarn people that there's heavy lifting involved. So anybody who would like to, who would be able to help, then please give your names to Margaret. The Daffodil Tea is on the 16th of March. Tickets and details are there. And this is one definitely for the brownies, the rainbows, and the guides as well. And that is the annual bunny hunt is coming up. So it happens before you go on holiday from school. It's the Saturday before then, and you come along, and if you find all the bunnies, then you get a roll on sausage, or is that right? A roll on sausage, or is that right? A roll in bacon, or a roll in sausage, right? Thank you. Right. So, whatever you feel like, then. So, there will be some crafts on sale then, which will help defray the costs with that. Just to say it's with sadness that I have to intimate that Walter White died unexpectedly on Friday afternoon in Ayr Hospital. He had been in hospital just for a week. Obviously, it's just a reasonably short time since Margaret passed away, and because of it being a Friday, and because of work being done at the crematorium, it's likely to be 2 to 3 weeks before we know the date of the funeral. But if you can remember John and Tina and their family and all of Walter's friends, please, and many of his friends were here in the church, so please remember him. Remember them in your prayers. Let's bring our prayers for other people. God of relationships, on this first Sunday of Lent, we pray that we spend this time actively seeking a relationship with you, that we notice your presence acting across the world and in our communities. We choose to fast by loosing the bonds of injustice and undoing the straps of so many people who are oppressed and suffering from abuse, as well as enduring unfair labour conditions across the world and in our communities too. This week marks United Nations World Day of Social Justice, raising our awareness by recognising that social development and justice are crucial if we are to find peace and security inside ourselves and among our community and among all nations. We cry out for peace amongst the nations, for peace amongst neighbours. And so we plead for strength to work for social development across the world, but most especially where we are, in our communities. Caring God, there are too many people struggling with lack of food, people in Africa forced to consume but the bulbs of the water lily because they've no other source of food. Acute food insecurity is evident in Afghanistan, in Gaza, in parts of Africa due to drought and war, where people rely on humanitarian aid, but that aid doesn't arrive. And so we ask that people might be moved to act in the face of the emergencies of our day, across the world, in our communities. We pray for our families and our friends. Touch the lives of those who are ill at this time in their own homes, undergoing examinations or treatment in our hospitals or in the care of our hospice. Be with all who have been bereaved. Let them know that at the depth of their grief, they can still find your comfort and your solace. Be with those who are lonely, those who feel their walk through life is a lonely walk, or who can't see the way ahead. Be with those who are struggling with problems. And in the silence of this moment, we bring to you those for whom we have a special concern this day, and we share their names with you, that as you care for them, we might learn how to care with you. Loving God, you are present across the world, in our community, here with us now. Help us to work with all your people, that all might know equal shares. So be it. Amen. Just before we have our next hymn, if I can draw your attention and encourage you to look at it, you may have, the eagle-eyed amongst you may have noticed that we've got a different king's colour with us today from the guides, and we'd like to say a word of thanks to all those who contributed to that being the case. Apparently colours are now quite difficult to find, but we look forward to having a company colour a district colour. District colour. You can always guarantee that I'll make mistakes when the regional commissioner here. anyway, we look forward to that, and I would encourage you to have a look at the King's Colour on your way out. But let's sing now in Longing for Light, We Wait in Darkness. Christ, be our light.
Thank you.
God save the King. Let us pray. Share your bread with the hungry. Share your resources with the needy. Share your goodness with the despised. Go now in peace and be peacemakers. And the blessing of God, our Creator, our companion, and our Comforter, be with us all this day and always. You shall go out with joy and be led forth with peace.
Hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injustice.